Good afternoon, everyone. This is Anirudh Devagupta, student of BSc Honors Forensic Science from Amity University. It's my honor and privilege to present my e-poster in front of Honorable Chairperson, respected jury, delegates, faculty, and my fellow members. I welcome you all, and without making any further delay, I'll begin with my presenting my e-poster on cloning of a fingerprint. I will walk you through all towards a glimpse of my presentation. In my nutshell, my presentation is all about the cloning of a fingerprint, how such hacking is possible, and how to avoid it. Moving towards the introduction, which is about the fingerprints, a scanner, and a hack. The pioneer in fingerprinting identification was Sir Francis Galton, and the fingerprints are defined as a unique pattern made by friction ridges and furrows, which appears on the pads of the fingers and thumbs, and which are grouped into four distinct types that are loops, burrs, arches, and composites. A scanner makes a copy of your fingerprint and compares its characteristics to the one stored beforehand in it. And these characteristics are measured based upon the spatial points on a print. The hack or a cloning is to create an artificial finger using a gelatin or a fabricol material to form a mold that is manufactured using the legitimate user's actual finger. Let's move towards the method and methodologies. At first, the equipment required for the cloning are the hot setting adhesive and a glue gun, gelatin leaves and fabricol, stove, kettle, and refrigerator, and at last the live finger. The method for creating a mold includes three steps: the creation of the mold, the creation of the finger, and the usage of the finger. The creation of the mold: we heat up the glue gun and spread the glue on a piece of paper and let it cool a bit. Now press the finger in the glue and also moisten the finger a bit before giving the impression. Slowly lift the finger and let the mold cool down to the room temperature. The print should be distinctively visible on the mold and be sure to avoid bubble formation in the mold. In the creation of the finger, the artificial finger is created by softening the gelatin sheets in the cold water and then putting it in the hot water while stirring it for 10 minutes. It will make a mixture and after cooling the mixture, pour it in the mold and put it in the refrigerator for 15 minutes. The longer, the better results you will get. Also take care that not making the finger too thick. After the coagulation of the gelatin material, separate it and handle the finger with care at the room temperature. Avoid warming it or it will melt down. We can see that the artificial finger will have a distinct fingerprint. In the unavailability of gelatin material, we can use fabricol also. The usage of the finger. After getting the artificial finger, place the artificial finger on the tip of the finger and scan it to the scanner. If it shows detection field, then avoid tryouts and try a new mold. Now I will brief you about a case that happened 2 months ago in Uttar Pradesh. A 26-year-old man was arrested by the police in Uttar Pradesh who learned fingerprint cloning and allegedly hacked 500 bank accounts. The police identified the man as Gaurav. According to the police, the Gaurav learned fingerprint cloning using glue gun and adhesive through the internet and colluded with Bank Mitra. He then withdrew money from the bank accounts of beneficiaries of various government schemes. After repeated complaints from many beneficiaries, the police launched a probe. The crime branch found that the money was credited in the beneficiary's account, but it was later withdrawn through the Jan Suvidha Kendra, which was being run by the Bank Mitra, according to the Times of India. The police said that it cost Gaurav less than ₹5 per cloning. The accused involved in the racket has been arrested by the police and is charged under the Section 467, forgery of valuable security, bills, etc. 468, forgery for purpose of cheating, 471, using a genuine forged document, and 420, cheating and dishonestly inducing delivery of property of the Indian Penal Code. The result of my experiment enlists that the artificial finger created was tested on fingerprint scanners of several mobile phones and laptops as well, and the results came out to be positive. But the test rate was not very high until a proper mold was made. And the cloning works best under when the adhesive solution is thick enough and the least bubble formation in the molded finger was formed. I will conclude it why this cloning is successful. This cloning is based on the fact that the gelatin material or the molded finger was about the same capacitance as the real finger. And thus the scanner we use is unable to distinguish between these two. Now, all that is needed is the gelatin finger that corresponds to the real finger or the legitimate finger and the accuracy level of the scan. But and now, what measures can we take to avoid such cloning? The easiest way to protect against that act is to avoid giving a mold of your fingers unknowingly. Another way to make things difficult for the hacker is to use several fingers in the authentication. Then to break into the system, the breakers need more than one mold, which is harder than getting just one mold by few. Also, certain advancements can be made in the scanners to distinguish between the actual and the hacked finger. This brings me to the end of my presentation. Now, I will summarize my presentation with my motives that first, creating an awareness regarding the possibility of hacking and cloning. Second, how one can avoid such attacks on personal level. And third, there is a need of upgradation of fingerprint scanners as the hackers are also evolving. Thank you so much. I'm grateful for your patience and time.